the year 2016. We have seen great smartphones this year. We have seen a great variation in the smartphone this year from the previous year smartphones. Many flagship high-end devices were made on Snapdragon 820 chipset. And now we have Google Pixel and Pixel XL on Snapdragon 821 chipset. The first phone to run on Snapdragon 821 chipset is out there. And these two smartphones will be available from 13th October in India. Hey, how are you guys? Your mate Pratik here. And in this video, we'll be comparing Google Pixel, Pixel XL and OnePlus 3. So let's just kick off with the video. The very first day I heard about Google Pixel, I was waiting for it. I didn't know who is going to manufacture it. The rumors were that HTC is going to manufacture this Google's Pixel. But now Pixel's hardware is firmly made by Google. Google owns its hardware, Google owns its software, and it's definitely a good piece of hardware used in the smartphone. We have the Snapdragon 821, the latest chipset, the best chipset out there in the market. And we have many other flagship smartphones too, which were launched in the year 2016. So when I think of Google Pixel, many other smartphones raised in my mind. Samsung S7, Note 7, iPhone 7 also. You guys might also be aware about all the issues coming in the iPhone 7 and Note 7. These two brands are really mature brands and we can't expect any type of mistakes from them. I may not make any comparison between the S7 Edge and Google Pixel. I'll be making a comparison between OnePlus 3 and Google Pixel in this video. I'll be starting the comparison from the screen. Google Pixel is having a screen of 5 inch, which is a 1080p Full HD display, while Google Pixel XL is having a 5.5 inch Quad HD display. And the OnePlus 3 has a Full HD 1080p display. Definitely Pixel XL wins the round here, as it has a Quad HD display. When we come to pixels per inch, OnePlus 3 has having a pixel density of 401 pixels per inch. Google Pixel is having a pixel density of 441 pixels per inch. And the Pixel XL is having a pixel density of 534 pixels per inch. And again, Pixel XL wins it. Google Pixel is at the second mark and OnePlus 3 is at last. Both the three smartphones are powered with a Gorilla Glass 4 display, so they will crack actually. But you need not worry that much. Gorilla Glass 4 is actually a little strong. Gorilla Glass 4 can easily resist small shocks and jerks. Google Pixel and Pixel XL comes with a RAM of 4GB, whereas OnePlus 3 is being powered with a RAM of 6GB. And about the storage, Pixel and Pixel XL are having two storage variants, 32GB and 128GB, while OnePlus 3 is having a 64GB storage variant. There are many out in the world who require a little more storage. So Pixel XL wins here, and also the Pixel wins here in the storage round. When we talk about the SIM card slot, OnePlus 3 is having a dual SIM card slot, while both the Pixel and Pixel XL have a single SIM slot. So OnePlus 3 takes the lead here. Three devices have a 4G VoLTE support. So these are almost similar here. All the three devices are having Bluetooth version 4.2, so Bluetooth speed will be almost similar. All three devices have a USB Type-C port, and OnePlus 3 supports the dash charging technology from Oppo, which was taken by OnePlus to install in their OnePlus 3, and this further makes the OnePlus 3 the fastest charging device in the world. Yes, it's the fastest charging device, the fastest charging phone actually in the world. It charges about 0 to 100 in less than 1 hour. When we talk about camera, OnePlus 3 is having a 16 megapixel camera, while the Pixel and Pixel XL are having the 12 megapixel camera. When we talk about the front facing camera, both the three devices have an 8 megapixel front facing camera, and this makes the camera almost similar in all the three devices. And I guess Google Pixel XL will be competing very good with OnePlus 3 in the camera round. Well, we can't say anything about camera just with the megapixel. Pixel and Pixel XL are the latest smartphones by Google, so definitely they will have the latest Android version, the Android Nougat version 7.1 in both the devices, Pixel and Pixel XL, while in OnePlus 3 we have Android 6.0 Marshmallow, and we hope the update to be coming very soon from OnePlus to OnePlus 3. all the three devices have a quad core processor clocked at 2.15 GHz, but the chipset is a little different. Pixel and Pixel XL are having a chipset of Snapdragon 821, well, the best one out there right now, and OnePlus 3 is having a chipset of Snapdragon 820. When we talk about GPU, all the three devices have an Adreno 530 GPU, so it will make the gaming performance really good. Google Pixel is having the least battery, that is 2770 mAh. OnePlus 3 has the second highest battery, it's 3000 mAh, while the Pixel XL has a 3440 mAh battery. This year I was unsatisfied from OnePlus just because the battery backup was really low on OnePlus 3. So we can expect a better battery backup on Google Pixel and Pixel XL. Even the Pixel is having the lesser battery, but the backup will be more than OnePlus 3. Due to many software lags in OnePlus 3, it consumes a little more battery. But yes, this makes the OnePlus 3 really very much slim. OnePlus 3 is just 7.4 mm thick, while the Pixel and Pixel XL are 8.6 mm thick. Google Pixel weighs about 143 grams, while the OnePlus 3 weighs about 158 grams, and the Pixel XL weighs about 168 grams. So definitely Google Pixel will be having a better grip. And when it comes to the price point, OnePlus 3 really wins with a huge score. OnePlus 3 costs about $399 and 28,000 rupees in India, while the Google Pixel costs about 56,000 in India for the 32GB variant and about $649 for the 32GB variant in US, $749 for the 128GB variant in US, while it costs about 66,000 rupees in India for the 128GB variant. And when we come to Pixel XL, Pixel XL costs about 67,000 Indian rupees for the 32GB variant and 76,000 for the 128GB variant. While in US it costs about $769 for 32GB variant and $869 for 128GB variant. Well, that's a really higher price than OnePlus 3, so OnePlus 3 wins. It's just far away from all the other devices. And even we are having S7 Edge in the market, a really good flagship device, so I can't expect a good sales for Google Pixel. Pricing makes all the difference. When I do not consider the pricing, I would rate the Pixel XL to be number 1, OnePlus 3 to be number 2, and the Google Pixel to be number 3. But when considering the price point, OnePlus 3 wins. It makes a huge difference. It's just the half the price of the Google Pixel and Pixel XL. I don't know what Google has done this time in the pricing. They would have improved the pricing and can get the market value. They would have provided the devices at a really good price to compete with other brands out there in the market, so that there would be very good value of these smartphones. People would be valuing these smartphones. So guys, that was a short comparison video. I hope you liked the video. Hit the like button if you liked the video. Hit the subscribe button to catch me up in my next videos. Thanks for watching. Namaste.